An economist tells the Philippine government to focus its attention on improving agricultural infrastructure instead of building a concert stadium. Economist Noel Leco tells Teleradio Serbicio improving agri-infrastructure will help the production capacity of local farmers, in turn improving food security and bringing down food prices. Leco is also alluding to a planned development in Clark, Pampanga, where the government wants to build a so-called Taylor Swift-ready concert stadium.
Lalo na po, magkaroon po ng tulong ang ating pong mga agricultural infrastructure. Yun pong i-modernize natin, yung ating agricultural infrastructure. Kalimutan na po natin na naiinggit tayo sa Singapore, hindi pupunta rito si sino yon? Si Taylor Swift. Eh, kailangan po natin, ang mga magsasaka natin, ang magkaroon ng tamang infrastruktura para po mas mataas o mas matatag ang kanilang produksyon, ang kanila pong agricultural production ay mas produktibo. Dito po dapat mapunta ang ating investment. Dito dapat mapunta ang ating mga subsidiya at dito po dapat mapunta ang ating mga long-term na mga intervention sa ating agrikultura.
Peasant groups staged a protest action outside the Department of Agriculture to call for the junking of the rice tariffication law. Jervis Manahan now joins us with that story. Jervis?
Yes, Denise, a few days before the before President Bongbong Marcos' third State of the Nation address, several peasant groups staged a rally in front of the central office of the Department of Agriculture in Quezon City. The group led by Dakilusang Magbubukid ng Pilipinas and Batay Bigas called for the junking of the rice tariffication law. They said this is just a preview of the larger protest action to be done on Monday on the Sona Day itself. Cathy Estavillo of Batay Bigas said hundreds of farmers from different regions all across the Philippines will join the Sona protests because it's the third year of the Marcos administration and they are alleging that the administration has not done anything to improve the state of agriculture in the country. The protest action was attended by dozens of youth and other allies from various sectors. They are also set to welcome more farmers coming in today and staying over the weekend to protest or join the protest this coming Monday. He peacefully ended the rally earlier today after an hour. Denise.
Jervis Manahan with that report. Thanks, Jervis. A state of calamity declared in flood-ravaged Pikit Cotabato. Local officials say over 15,000 families in 18 villages have been affected. Relief efforts continue for the flooded communities. Meanwhile, heavy rains also affecting parts of northern Cebu. It forced nearly 200 individuals to evacuate in the town on San Remigio. The Provincial Disaster Risk Reduction and Management Office is still assessing the damage brought about by the rains. Senator Juan Miguel Zubiri joins the call to ban pogos. The former Senate president suggests giving pogos a year or two to transition, then the government can impose a total ban. He adds the revenues from pogos are not enough to justify criminal and immoral activities linked to them. Senator Joel Villanueva also lauded business groups for supporting the call to ban pogos. He is now hoping President Marcos will announce a total ban on pogos in his upcoming State of the Nation address on Monday. The House panel also looking into the possible culpability of Porac Mayor Jaime Capil in the raided illegal pogo hub in his town. The chairperson of the House Committee on Public Order and Safety, Congressman Dan Fernandez, says Mayor Capil had more than enough time to close down the establishment but didn't. Fernandez says they will investigate Capil's lifestyle and assets to see if he received any payoffs from the Pogo Hub.
Ang hirap lang i-accuse without the actual evidence, you know. Pero I don't believe on him. Hindi ako naniniwala sa kanya. You are going to ask me, you know, as a former mayor, diba? Eh, ang tanga mo. Kapag hindi mo alam kung nangyayari sa isang lugar mo, what is the 100 million reason? Bakit hindi mo siya pinaglap? Kasi yun ang procedure, Carmina, eh. Kapag hindi sila nag-comply, hindi nila inaayos yung kanilang mga violation, padlock mo para hindi na nakakapasok yung mga empleyado.